Hi, welcome back to my channel and happy Saturday. Today I thought I would share with you how I am going to repurpose this Happy Planner Classic Size as my catch-all planner. Now this is a planner that I used earlier this year. It was a vertical planner. I took all the guts out because I do like the cover. It doesn't have a year on it to indicate that, you know, this is a 2023 planner. And, you know, I like all the pet portraits that are on here. Now this is a block paper that has mini on it. I purchased this on sale a couple of years ago from Joanne online. Joanne's online. I have a lot of these and I wanted to use them all up because that's my goal for 2024 too, is to try to use up what I have instead of hoarding all the things that I have, like the stickers, the washi tape, and again, these pads of paper from Happy Planner. So let me show you what I've done in here. Like these dividers. As of right now, I'm not gonna cover the tabs. I probably will in the end, but as of right now, I'm gonna leave that alone. Now, if you are new to Happy Planner, on their divider page, they have the month layout here. Half a month, then the other half would be on this side. And so what I did was I got a blank note page, put down some washi, and then just taped over it so that I have a blank page on this side. Now this is a bill tracker that I've been using for the past year or two, and I think I may have shown it in like my After the Pin videos when I was sharing my Happy Planner with you. And so I plan to continue with that. I like this because at a glance for a given month, and in this case it's January 2024, I can tell what bills came in, when they're due, how much we owe on it, if we paid on it, how much we paid, and then I would check it off if we paid it. So this for me is pretty handy to have, and so underneath it I have December and November, the pages here. And so I plan on continuing to do this. And this is another Happy Planner Disney sheet that I picked up once again on sale from Joanne's. Now this is a blank, well it's not blank, I did cover up our bills, you know, our credit cards, everything. I covered it up, but this is a year at a glance of how much we paid every single month. So this is for 2023, basically the same thing except up on top. Let me take this off. Up on top, you can see that I have the months. And so this is something that I created, I think in Google Docs, maybe, Google Documents. And so I have the bills listed over here. And then so every month that we pay our bill, I will write down how much we paid. And that way I can keep track in a year how much we paid for each bill. And so that's why I have 6 months on this one, 6 months on this one. I think this will help us kind of understand whether our bills, whatever it is, whether it's water, gas, electric, is going up or down. And so I created this for us. This is our change your air filter date sheet. This I printed out from Cookie Monster Co. I whited this out and I put date on top. This I'm going to use to keep track of anything that I buy stationery wise for 2024. And I'm hoping to spend any money on stationery during the year of 2024 other than Hobonichi. If I buy anything, I plan to keep track, putting down the date, the shop, and then the amount spent. Now this is one of the sheets that I used. Here I really want to try to keep track of my habits for December. So sticker flake that I purchased in one of the sticker packs that I purchased from Etsy. The stamp, I stamped 9 times. And the stamp itself, I think I purchased from Kimu a few weeks, months ago. And so up here, I just wrote Sunday through Saturday, and I just wrote it up on top so that when I look down at the other ones, I know, because it's December stamped 9 times, I know what the day of the week is. In this case, I am going to start tracking what I've read. I'm hoping to read 1 chapter minimum a day. I'm going to keep track of the rain because I need to know when I am or am not watering our back garden. Here is watering my houseplants and when I fertilize my houseplants. I'm not really good with this, keeping track. And I generally am a plant owner that likes to lift up their pot to decide whether or not my plant needs water. I just want to place myself on a better schedule, as well as a better schedule for my plants. Here, I want to get back into exercising again. And then I have a spot, two spots, if I want to add something there. So I need to decide what I want to put there that I want to track for the rest of the month. And so you can see I have some blank pages here. And these are the rest of the note paper that I have from Happy Planner. If you don't like Mickey, you don't like the Disney brand, they do sell other note paper with different designs on it. Like right now, I think they have like Christmas note paper. I don't know if it's on sale. They have different themes. I may create a book list of books that I want to read or books that are coming out for 2024. And I have enough note pages here to keep track of it. So I hope this gives you an idea of how to repurpose a happy plant. I'm hoping to use less next year planner-wise, and I'm hoping that this will satisfy my need to track my habit in one notebook, in one place, so that my kitchen table isn't stacked up with my different planners. So if you liked the video, give it a thumbs up. If you didn't, give it a thumbs down. Subscribe if you'd like to see. I generally do after the pin videos of my Hobonichi cousin. Have a good weekend. Happy holidays. I'll see you guys later. Bye.